Welcome to your love reading for July 2021. This can extend a little past the month, but it's meant for the time frame of July. And we're going to be picking a card from each oracle deck here. We've got Romance Angels and we have Whispers of Love Tarot deck. Those descriptions are below if you'd like to check them out. And I also will be choosing some tarot card decks to choose from, or excuse me, I'm no longer thinking about what I'm saying. This one feels right. Speak the language of love. Loving words have the power to change lives, including your own. Yeah, we're gonna get a feel real quick for which Libras we're talking to, so that we don't waste anybody's time. Of course, if it resonates, you keep it. If it doesn't, then move on. Please hit the like and the subscribe button if this sounds right to you, if this resonates. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to doing more readings for you even this week. We have the monthly readings already on the channel up for July, and that covers career, finances, and relationships, so check those out. Okay, focusing on romance, love messages for Libra, month of July. Please make it clear. Thank you. So, in conjunction with our Whispers of Love, we have romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. Cool. Explore them, speak them. Yeah, this is all about expression so far. So let's give this a little shuffle. So we're gonna get some insight on where Libra's at right now. Which Libras are we speaking to? Some healing here, possibly also being in the limelight a little bit, being noticed, but definitely the Star card talks about getting your wish, healing. Queen of Pentacles, nurturing energy, hardworking and generous with their earnings, and that's the way they can nurture through their generosity that way. That doesn't feel right. I'm not going to take it. Okay, Libras. There we go. Queen of Wands. We have two people here. We have somebody who's got the energy of being quite outgoing. Now, this can be male, female, anybody, any between. And Queen of Wands is an outgoing energy, bold, charismatic, can be quite popular. They speak with their actions oftentimes. They're instinctual. They run heavily on instinct. We also have another character, someone who's quite nurturing, soft, but hard. And I'll explain what I mean there, is they can be so hardworking, but they can be quite nurturing. So they have quite a bit of versatility there. They tend to like nice quality things. Who are the Libras that we're speaking to? The Lover's card comes out. Now this could be a partnership. Very easily, right? If we're going to take it literally. Lovers is also ruled by Gemini energy. Sometimes there's a decision to be made here, right? Okay, anything else for Libras? Healing. So we've got the healing card. So this is popping back up in regards to these two individuals, one of whom I'm sure is you. Okay, so now I'm gonna get some insight on where you should be going with love in July. What energies are you saying yes to, Libra? What are you saying yes to, Libra? Page of Wands. I'm focusing on the happiness, focusing on the good times, you know? Saying yes to the good times. Strength. This is going forward, but analyzing the situation, going forward strategically and carefully. Justice, what's right for you? You know? What's right for you? Why do things happen? Where's the balance to this? Where's the truth and the balance? Justice card. I mean, Libra knows all about balance. What are you being asked? This really is popping in my head strong, Libra. What are you being expected and asked to do that might be throwing you out of balance in this relationship? Okay? And then I turn this over and there's the Devil card. Okay. Yeah, you're being, there's a behavioral pattern here. For some of you, there might be even an addiction in there somewhere. But either way, when you zoom out, it's the same. It's just this behavioral pattern that is not serving you and something that holds a lot of potential. But you're being called to do it another way. Being called to do it another way. Yeah. Your heart can get you stuck here. And so you're being called to be strategic, analyze the situation, go forward carefully from a place of balance and truth and justice, and karmically what's right and right for you in order not to repeat a pattern, okay? Because when you follow, if you just come from your heart place, you only come from that compassionate place, which is a beautiful, beautiful place like Libra. You know it's beautiful. I don't need to tell you that, but I'm going to remind you that that place is actually kind of getting you into a stuck feeling, okay? And you can take this blindfold off anytime you choose. But to take the blindfold off requires that you're going to have to do a little bit of resorting, you know? You're going to have to readjust some things in order to find balance. So it looks like there is definitely another person in the picture already that you're getting healing with. And I go back to your oracle card of romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. So not running away from how you feel about this person, but actually just being legit and real with yourself. And there was an imbalance here and you're being called to address that imbalance. If that means that now for some of you, it might not feel safe or to talk to that person about this, but really you're being beckoned by the cards to call upon your ability of language to speak this out. And if that means not directly to them, at least out into the world and into prayer, or write them a letter that you don't send, or hell, maybe that you do send. What are we not doing? Queen of Swords, being harsh with your words. You know, that truth is important to address, but also reflects on you as well. And when you are harsh with your words, you can shut people down pretty quickly. It's really one thing to know the truth in harsh light of day, but to express it with that same harshness is not necessary, okay? So what do we not do? Okay, we've got Magician. What are we getting clarity on with a Magician? The Hanged Man. This is Piscean energy. This can be slowed up energy. Okay. Don't force a perspective, okay, Libra? This is what it's telling me. Don't try and force a perspective. Don't try to make them have an epiphany the way that you did, okay? Don't try to restart something here, okay? So the cards are saying, please, Libra, you know, trying to get somebody to see it your way, hoping for a restart in something or a fresh offer to come out of that is probably something that shouldn't be expected here. You're definitely, oh no, we got a one flipped card. We have the World card that is flipped over inside the deck, and we have the King of Pentacles. So we're not reading them because they didn't fly out, but I did want to just throw that out your way to be fair. What else do we not do for Libra? The Moon card. I'm gonna put that back in the deck, but Moon card is fear, is working from a place of fear. Nope, you're being called definitely to work back in from a place of balance and strength. Yeah. So it's like don't try to force that perspective, even though you had some realizations and epiphanies around balance with this, and breaking out of a cycle. You can't force that perspective through the harsh light of day towards another person, right? And expect that you're gonna have this breakthrough. I hope that's pretty clear. This is all very positive though. It feels very much like you're getting healing with a person and you're very much achieving balance in the month of July. And remember your oracle card here. Speak the language of love. Loving words have the power to change lives, including your own. All right. Yeah, you are definitely in your power in the realm of expression this month, Libra. Hit the like button, please hit the bell. I love you and I'm wishing the best for you. Go check out your monthly readings. It covers finances and relationships. I just loaded them up. You can do it on my channel. Okay, take care.